Hello everyone, how are you doing? This is MD Tech here with another quick tutorial. In today's tutorial, I'm going to show you guys how to hopefully resolve if there are no power options currently available on your Windows computer. So perhaps they're currently grayed out or you're unable to actually access them. This tutorial will be for you. So this should hopefully be a pretty straightforward process, and we're going to go ahead and jump right into it. And we're going to start by opening up the Start menu. Just left click on the Start button one time. Type in Troubleshoot. Best match should come back with Troubleshoot Settings. Go ahead and just left click on that one time to open up the troubleshooting options. On the right side underneath Find and Fix Other Problems, you want to scroll down until you get to Power. Find and fix problems with your computer's power settings to conserve power and extend battery life, and then left click on Run the Troubleshooter. So it might give you some suggestions here. I'd suggest either applying or skipping the fix. So it's suggesting that we apply a more efficient power plan. So if you want to try doing that, you want to select apply. Otherwise, just off click on skip. And you can see that's basically giving you a suggestion here. We chose not to go along with it. But in other cases, if maybe you wanted to enable more power efficiency, that would be able to hopefully resolve some of your issue. So once you're done with that, go ahead and close out of here. Now, another thing you can try if you're running Windows 10 Professional or Higher Edition would be to go ahead and open up the Start menu and type in Local Security Policy. Best match should come back with Local Security Policy here. Go ahead and right-click on that and then run as administrator. Don't believe you actually need to run it as administrator, but I usually just like to do it anyway. And now in the local security policy window here, you want to go and expand underneath local policies, double click on it or left click on a little arrow next to it to expand the drop down. And now you want to left click on the user rights assignment folder. Now on the right side, you want to look for something that says shut down the system. And you want to right click on it and left click on properties. You want to select backup operations, so left click on that one time, and then left click on where it says add user or group. Now you want to take note of whatever your... Now you want to open up the Start menu while this is still open, and you want to type in Control Panel. Best match should come back on Control Panel. Go ahead and left click on that one time. You want to scroll down here until you get to user accounts. Make sure your view by is set to large icons and then select user accounts. And left click on where it says configure advanced user profile properties. So left click on that. And take note of whatever the name is following the desktop name, or it might say laptop or whatever. After this forward slash, take note of this name in here. So we close out of here. I'm going to type in my username, which is MDTech. And then you want to left click on check names. You can see now it'll add the same letters that showed up before on the user profile screen. And then left click on OK. And then left click on apply and OK. Close out of here, restart your computer, and hopefully that should be able to resolve the problem. If you are still experiencing an issue here and you're running Windows 10 Home Edition in which you do not have access to the local security policy, I'm going to show you guys a way to do that as well. So open up the Start menu, type in regedit, so R-E-G-E-D-I-T. Best match should come back with Registry Editor. You want to right click on that and then left click on Run as Administrator. If you receive a user account control prompt, you want to go ahead and left click on Yes. Now before you proceed in the registry, I would highly suggest that you make a backup of it. And in order to do that, it's very simple. Just go ahead and left click on the File tab up at the top left, left click on Export. For the file name, usually the date in which you're making the backup is usually a pretty smart decision. Export range should be selected to all, and then save it to a convenient location on your computer. Click on save, And then if you ever need to come back from that backup, just to do file import and navigate over to the file. So pretty straightforward. And once you've made your backup, now you want to expand the HK current user folder. So you either double click on the folder or left click on a little arrow next to it to expand the dropdown. Do the same thing now for the software folder. Same thing for Microsoft. Same thing now for Windows. So go down to Windows, expand Windows. Do the same thing now for current version. You want to go down to Policies, expand that, and then left go on the Explorer folder. On the right side, there should be something that says No Close. You want to go ahead and double click on that. You want to change your value data to 0. So make sure it says 0 inside this value data box, and then left go on OK. Close out of here, restart your computer, and hopefully that should be about it. So as always, thank you guys for watching this brief tutorial. I do hope I was able to help you out, and I do look forward to catching you all in the next tutorial. Goodbye.